kind of liken it to like new money, old school love, because we met on a forum on Facebook that I was a part of and she was a part of.
I was a part of a panel discussion called Is Dating Dead? And so that was an event that took place, and shortly thereafter they had a Facebook group created.
We started talking, and I don't know, we just had a real nice vibe and connection, especially about every discussion and topic in regards to relationships. It was called Dating Is Dead, Who Killed It?
And so I had been in the group conversing with people for a couple of months, and then all of a sudden this robber guy pops up, and he was like, well, according to the beautiful today, I'm like, who is this guy?
I had made a little slick comment to her one day, and everybody picked up on it.
And then me being the smart bud that I am, I thought it'd get slick one day. I said, so I asked him a question. I don't even remember what it was. And then he mentioned, well, that's an in-person conversation. I'm like, what do you mean an in-person conversation?
She had made a little comment about, well, you know, if Robert wanted to ask me out or anything like that, you know, he can do it on his own. And I said, well, we can make this happen tomorrow.
And then I got slick and slid into the little DM. I was like, so when we gonna have this in-person conversation? He said, we can make this happen in 3 days. I was like, well, all right then. Somebody who was direct and knew what they wanted was very impressive to me.
I slid in the DM, and from there it was what we had today, 3 years later. For me, it was kind of like love at first sight when I saw her. I knew on the second day that I would marry her.
Robert was the one. One, because I had three principles that I lived for: to protect, serve, and love. And that was to protect me and my future family, to serve God, and to love me unconditionally. And when I met Robert, he had a very strong foundation rooted in God, and that meant a lot to me. And then the element of protect and serve, Robert reminded me so much of my father. My father is everything to me. And so, to be able to trust somebody with my heart is a lot for me. And when he stood up to reassure me that he had me hands down and would be willing to sacrifice anything for me, I knew he would be the one that I could say yes to.
We've just grown together a lot. She's helped me to be a better man, and she loves Akaya, and that's huge. Someone who I can trust with the most precious thing that I have in my life is very hard to come by. And for God to have blessed me with that, man, I can't thank him enough. Long story short, it was really just the Holy Spirit. You know, I think the way God intended marriage, which is holy matrimony, there's a certain ebb and flow. And they have intuition, obviously. But I think some of the little bit of intuition that we have as men is your spirit is just at peace with that huge understanding that this is, you're looking at your wife.
Robert, Tania, the Bible teaches that marriage is a permanent relationship of one man and one woman, freely and totally committed to each other as companions for life. Our Lord declared that a man shall leave his father and mother and unite with his wife in the building of a home, and the two shall become one flesh. The home that you're building is a home that's to be built upon love, for God is love. And it's the virtue that Paul portrayed in the 13th chapter in his letter to the Corinthian church, where it says, love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous or boastful, it's not arrogant or rude, love does not insist on its own way, it's not irritable or resentful, it does not rejoice at wrong, but rejoices in the right. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. So faith, hope, love abide these three, but the greatest of these is love. Forever.
Wishing you'd come back to me.